Of all of the Buzz of Madison County programs you may have heard over the past year, this one bears some of the most important advice. Advice for Christmas. No, it's not to tell you about refraining from extended family gatherings this year because of COVID, even though that is an important message. This week, we revisit Malia Stringer, Executive Director of the Animal Protection League. And Malia tells us that no matter how good your intent is, it's not a good idea to adopt a pet to surprise someone for Christmas.
No, it's not a good idea. Here at the Animal Protection League, we do have an adoption process. We do ask that people do not give us gifts. We like to have the person who is getting the animal to be the one who fills out the application and to be the one who that we talk with and fit the pet with.
Now, while Malia is an advocate for finding good homes for the shelter animals, she said there's a better way to go about this.
It's always a good idea to have the animal meet the child to make sure that that child and that animal in particular are going to be compatible, because some animals do not like children. And some animals do well with children who are quiet and do not do well with children that are loud and boisterous, and vice versa. So it's really, I don't feel that it's ever a good idea to adopt an animal for a child without having a child meet that animal first to make sure it's going to be a good fit.
And in many cases, the child isn't the only one the new pet should be meeting.
There's also a meet and greet with other animals in the home. So if you have other dogs in the home, and you're going to adopt a dog, then we would ask that they meet as well to make sure they're going to be compatible as well.
Now, if indeed you are passionate about giving for the season, or you want to spread the love, Malia says there's a way for you to help.
All shelters will always need donations, supplies, cleaning supplies, anything that they use. They also need financial donations to help run the shelter. That's a given for every shelter and everywhere in the country. We always use bleach, the kind that kills 99.9% of the germs. We like the Clorox wipes. And we need laundry detergent as well.
And she said if you just can't resist being around the fur babies,
we can always use volunteers. We do have a volunteer process where you fill out an information form. Then we take you on an orientation just to get you familiar with what we do here. And then you can come in and pretty much do what you want. But we always need volunteers to do so many things.
But again, if you need more convincing not to give a pet as a surprise Christmas gift, Malia has this.
If you're adopting a pet from a shelter, the animal is going to be stressed. The typical rule of thumb is an animal needs 3 days to decompress, 3 weeks to learn your routines, and 3 months to feel comfortable in your home. So if you have a house that's going to be full of guests and it's going to be loud and boisterous and you're not going to have a lot of time with those animals, you are setting them up for failure. So I would wait until after the holidays, unless you have a very quiet lifestyle where you're going to be able to really pay attention to that pet.
Malia Stringer of the Animal Protection League in Anderson, thank you for spending a few minutes with us and for your valuable insight. This has been a tough year, devastating for many. And since this is our last buzz together before Christmas this coming week, I'd like to express my hope that you're able to reflect and find some blessing in this season. And be sure to check in with someone that may be missing someone this Christmas. And whether you're observing Hanukkah, Christmas, Kwanzaa, or something else, this is my sincere wish that you have a happy one.
If only in my dreams.
Thanks for listening.